Hey everybody, it's already the end of April, I don't know how that happened, and so I wanted to share with you a few of the beauty products that I have been digging this month. It is a really heavy skincare edition. I find that a lot of the products, as I was going through everything and kind of peeking and seeing what I had really fallen for this month, a lot of them were skincare, so skincare centric. The number one biggest product that I have just been like obsessed with is this SkinCeuticals LHA Cleansing Gel. It has three different types of exfoliants. It has salicylic acid, it has glycolic acid, and then it also has something called LHA, which stands for, I wanna say it's lipohydroxy acid, which is another derivative of sal acid. So basically it's two kinds of sal acid and a glycolic acid. It's specifically designed for problem skin. So if you're like me and you're acne prone and you know, you try a new product cause you're like, ooh, everyone's talking about it, it must be great. And then your skin totally breaks out. This is the solution for you. I cannot recommend this product more highly. I'm in love with it. I use it twice a day, morning and night, and I've seen dramatic results in my skin. Those little bumps, the cystic acne, just the random zits, they've all been clearing up, so I really, really, really dig this product. Secondly, because apparently my acne this month has not been confined to my face, I've really been loving the Neutrogena Body Clear Body Wash. This is an oldie but a goodie. I've used this multiple times over the years, but my husband actually turned me back onto it. I was kind of bitching about having little breakouts all over my back and neck, and he was like, hey, why don't you use that product that you told me about, which he uses. So I stole it from him and put it in my shower, and I've been using it for the past few weeks, and you know, sure enough, the salicylic acid cleared up all of my back knee, I hate that term, but the little bumps I'd had on my back and neck and shoulders, totally gone, you know, in the matter of like a week. So it's really a great miracle product. Thirdly, this is a product by Amala. Amala is a skincare brand that they're based in Germany. I actually discovered them last year when I went on a press trip. I went all the way to Germany and to Austria? To Germany and Switzerland. And we toured the Amala Beauty headquarters in Germany in a town called Eu-Mittelburg. We got to see the factory and see how the products are produced. And it's like the most amazing, natural, organic, good for you, you know, it's like sourced from all over the world, the best. You know, they use acai, they go to Brazil and get the acai from the rainforest, and they use, you know, just like the best organic ingredients from all over the world. And they have these like super, super high-tech rooms and labs where everything is like containment-free, and they'll only use the highest quality and the purest doses and this and that, and they keep it in containers where the sun can't get in because that changes the formula. And it was like really a very illuminating and impressive factory tour. And the Amala products are not cheap. And so when I went on this press tour, they took us, you know, we went through the tour and saw everything. And then at the end, you go through the gift shop and they were like, oh, and you know, because you're here on our press tour, you know, we'll let you buy whatever you want at like a 50% discount, something like that. Because obviously, you know, I'm a beauty writer. I'm used to getting products for free because you get a lot of stuff sent to you. So I was like, buy products at a discount. Like, okay, whatever. Fast forward to, you know, 2 months later when I'd run through all the products they'd given me, and I was like, wait, wait, I need more Amala. Oh my God, I'm out. Because their products are just so amazing. My skin just really, really took to them. And I have very finicky, kind of acne, oily, you know, combination skin that breaks out at the slightest provocation and just really needs like the perfect products to be happy. And this particular product, this is the Narcissus Advanced Brightening Emulsion. I was using this with the Cocoa Bean Moisturizer. And I was like, all right, you know what? I'm out, fine, I'll buy the products. I go to the website and I'm like, oh my God, these are really expensive. Like this particular serum was $100 and the Cocoa Moisturizer is like $250 or something like that. I mean, it is really, really expensive, but it's really, really good. It was one of the best products I've ever used on my skin in like 13 years of being a beauty writer. So anyhow, I finally caved. I've been trying some other products here and there the past couple months. They've been good, you know, some of them have been very good, but it's like I wasn't feeling my kind of, you know, soulmate product. So finally, like I said, I caved, I bought this, and I'm so happy that we're reunited. It's so exciting. And it sinks in really well. It goes well under makeup. You can put a heavier cream on top. I sometimes use this with a Kiehl's product that I'll talk more about in a future video. And it's great because it doesn't break out your skin. It helps to reduce any discoloration that you have. And again, it uses all natural ingredients to brighten you up while it's doing it. So Amala Beauty, check it out. It is a great line, but not very cheap. Another product I have been super digging is this Caudalie Vino Body Butter. Vine Body Butter. You can see where my mind is. Caudalie just opened up a boutique in Venice on Abbot Kinney. Went to that store opening a few weeks ago, got a few of their products, and I've been trying them and really liking them. But this body butter is to die for. It's so yummy. It's like super duper thick. I put it on in the morning after my shower, and it makes me so happy. It smells so good. It has like a citrusy smell that has a little bit of like a sweet tart tang. It's just really, really yummy. This is the kind of scent that you can slather all over your body and not even wear perfume because you're just like emanating goodness. It's very, very thick, but it also seeps in pretty well, so you can put it on and I don't need to be like wandering around naked for 20 minutes before putting my clothes on. It's very hydrating, and then Caudalie is obviously a vino therapy line, so it's a line that's all about the ingredient resveratrol, which are the antioxidant properties that are found in wine, grapeseed extract, etc. And so it's good for you, it smells good, it feels good, it's just a really, really awesome body butter, and I love it. What else? Let me see. Okay, so last month I did a video about Josie Maran. This is one product in particular that I love. And this is the, it's called Argan Love Your Lips Hydrating Lipstick. This particular color is Playful Pink, which I have on. You can see there. And what's so cool, if you can see, is that there, maybe you can't see, is that there is a little tube of color in the middle, and then around it, there's the argan oil. So it's like a combination lipstick and moisturizer in one. You can just slick it on, gives you a really great color, but then also it's super, super moisturizing and hydrating. So I actually keep these in my purse, and I'll use these in place of chapstick, because it's like all of the hydration benefits of a chapstick or a lip butter, but you have a little bit of color too. Finally, I was on Larchmont over in like East LA near Highland Park a couple days ago, Hancock Park, and I saw that there is a new Diptyque boutique that's opened. It's the very first boutique in LA, so of course I like wandered in and had to buy all these things. Diptyque is one of my favorite like bath lines, candle lines. They have this candle, Bais. I've always thought it was pronounced Bais, but she pronounced it like Bays. So, Bays candle. Anyhow, this is one of their most popular scents. Smells like figs. It smells so good. Their candles are so not cheap. It's like really, really expensive. I think they're hovering around like $50, $60, something like that. So I've had this candle for a while now, and as you can see, it has not been burned at all because I don't want to use it, which is so like counter to my philosophy on candles and my philosophy on life. I feel like life is short, you should use it. Drink the good wine, burn the candle, break the plastic off, get messy. You know, that all sounds well and good in theory, but when it comes to burning my beloved expensive candles, I'm like, ah. So I'm trying to bring myself to actually burn this because it smells so good. And one of the cool things I discovered while at the boutique is that they are now selling skincare. I got a couple little samples. They have, actually the samples I have here are not the traditional skincare, but they have facial cleansers, they have facial oils and serums and all like toners and all sorts of amazing goodness. Right here I have just little samples of like the hand wash. This is L'Ombre dans l'eau, which is the same scent as the Bais / Bays candle, and this is a body lotion. And then little samples of the Eau de Toilettes. There is the Eau de Lavande and Geranium Odorata. So if you are so lucky as to have a Diptyque boutique near you, I know they have one in New York. Whenever I've been in London, at like Liberty of London, I always go into the Diptyque mini boutique, and they of course have them at department stores. Here's a little amber mini candle too. But if you ever go by the Diptyque boutique, be sure to ask for some samples of their new skincare line. They are actually very generous with them. And you can of course get samples of little eau de toilettes and body lotions and things like that too. And Diptyque, by the by, is one of the best products I've found, one of the best lines for gifting. So if you're going to a party or a birthday or it's Christmas or whatever, everyone loves getting a Diptyque candle in their stocking, so it is a really great gift. So that is it. Those are my April favorites. Thanks for watching. I will be doing more videos soon. You know what's funny is the only reason I don't do videos more frequently is I hate getting like all dolled up for them, like putting my hair up and doing my makeup and this and that. And so I often only do them when I already have my hair and makeup done. And today, you know, I'm like in a very sort of messy, like whatever ponytail, and I just kind of slapped on some makeup this morning. And I was like, screw it. I'm not really camera ready, but I'll do a video. And I actually posted a makeup free selfie on my Instagram yesterday, and I was like, you know, I should just do makeup-free videos sometimes. And you know, it's something I've done over the years on my blog, which is write about positive body image and esteem, and you know, not having to hide behind makeup and not having to hide your flaws. But I feel like people on YouTube don't necessarily always want to see that. You know, it's like we live in this beauty landscape of 18-year-olds as experts giving beauty advice, and everyone kind of like in their bedrooms talking to their cameras about makeup, you know. So sometimes it's hard to figure out like where to go and where you're taking these videos. That was kind of hilarious. I'm like having an honest moment, my camera stopped recording while I'm talking about like beauty and truth and all of that online. But anyhow, that's that. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.